On the 3rd of April, 1989, the acting Minister of Defense of the German Democratic Republic, Generaloberst Fritz Strelitz, communicated that there was no longer an order to fire to prevent people from illegally crossing the border. 5 days later, this sequence of photographs was taken. This is the history behind the pictured events. To understand the significance of these events, we have to first examine the legal and political situations which predated them. On paper, the usage of firearms to prevent an immediate criminal offense was justified by law, since the implementation of the law regarding the state border of the German Democratic Republic of March 25, 1982. Paragraph 2 of Article 27 states that border troops are allowed to use firearms to prevent or stop criminal offenses as well as to seize suspects. To do so, they must have exhausted all other means and fire a warning shot first. The Penal Code of the German Democratic Republic states that the preparation and attempt to cross the border outside the official process is illegal and will be punished with imprisonment, probation, fines, or public reprimand. This, of course, does not mean that there was no violent prevention of illegal border crossing before 1982. The Project Chronik der Mauer lists at least 140 people who died between 1961 and 1989 at the Berlin Wall or due to an immediate connection to the regime. At the end of the 1980s, the German Democratic Republic faced various internal crises. The border to Western Germany was an especially delicate concern. The leadership of the SED, the ruling party, feared that deaths at the border could further damage the reputation of Eastern Germany. This was the reason why on the 3rd of April 1989 they decided to suspend the usage of firearms at the border. A protocol from the Stasi archive of the 4th of April documents the following. Regarding the use of firearms at the state border, if the Minister of National Defense says that there is no order to fire, then it is also not allowed to shoot at the border or the Minister of Defense will lose credibility. It is not allowed to shoot on fleeing people if there is no order to fire. It has to be enforced that only if the body and life of the soldiers at the border are at risk, it is allowed to fire. On the same day, the decision was communicated to all relevant subdivisions and border crossings. One of these border crossings is the Grenzübergangsstelle Chausseestraße, where these pictures were taken. On the 8th of April, one of the last attempted escapes from the German Democratic Republic took place here. In the months leading up to the 8th of April, Bert Kaiser and Michael Bachmann, both 27, began planning their escape to the West. After a number of his friends already had left for West Germany, Kaiser began thinking about leaving in 1988. For him, there were only two possible ways in which direction the future of the politically unstable East Germany could develop. Either it will fall apart, or the restrictions will tighten even more. So Kaiser and Bachmann decided to escape. The plan was to surprise the border patrol and slip through the border crossing at the Chausseestraße on a busy Saturday. To improve their chances at succeeding, they started training sprints and hurdles at the Stadion der Weltjugend, one of the biggest stadiums of the German Democratic Republic, where the Eastern German renditions of the Weltfestspiele took place. As their plan depended on the border patrol being busy, they chose the sunny and warm 8th of April for their escape. On that Saturday morning, they met at the stadium to warm up, run a few laps, and soon made their way to the border crossing. At 9:30 a.m, they were in position. The barrier went up to let a car through. Bert Kaiser and Michael Bachmann started running, 150 meters to freedom. The Stasi report, which documented the incident that day, describes how 13 people were waiting at the pre-inspection area. As the stationed officer was controlling a car and the barrier went up, suddenly two of them started running in the direction of the border. To slow, to physically stop the runners, the officer took approximately 7 seconds to activate the alarm. In that time frame, they had already reached the customs control and jumped over a closed 80 cm barrier. The officers there were doing administrative work, so Greiser and Bachmann were able to continue uninterrupted, jumping over a 138cm high fence. The officer responsible for the passport control was occupied by Western tourists when the runners passed the station. He tried to pursue them, but was not able to reach them. The last officer, stationed at the Grenzübergang Chausseestraße, which had the most time to react to the alarm and the escape of Greiser and Bachmann, positioned himself, after seeing them running towards the border, at the fence adjacent to the street. Everything according to protocol. According to the Stasi report, at that point in time, Greiser and Bachmann had split and were both only meters away from crossing the border. As from the viewpoint of the officer, stopping runners with only physical effort was not possible anymore. He drew his gun. Immediately before that, the officer, later identified as Stasi Captain Karl-Heinz B., from the Postkontrolleinheit, a subdivision of the Stasi, later called Kippeschütze by the Western media, had looked into the direction of a viewing pedestal in Western Germany, where three men and a woman were positioned with field glasses and camera in hand. They were friends of Bert Kreiser's, who he asked to come record their escape, in case they failed, or, if they succeeded, for a good story. The iconic pictures of the escape, later falsely attributed to a film crew of the Berliner Abendschau, were taken by them and later distributed to Western newspapers. Shortly before the shot was heard, they were calling, "Run! Run!" The reconstruction of the escape by the Stasi shows the trajectory the bullet of the gun of Stasi Captain Karl-Heinz B. took. The report states that the shot passed 2 meters parallel to the border, above the faster runner, Bert Kreiser. After the shot, according to the Stasi it was a warning shot, something Bert Kreiser later denied in an interview, both runners immediately stopped running and were arrested by multiple officers. Bert Kreiser was only 40 meters away from the border, as the shot stopped the escape, a tenth of the way they ran that Saturday morning. When he was later asked why he stopped, Kreiser answered that he and Michel Baumann had promised themselves to immediately stop running if one of the border officers used a firearm. They wanted freedom, not death. Bert Kreiser and Michel Baumann were sentenced to 22 and 20 months, respectively, of jail time for their attempt to cross the border illegally. The sentences were carried out in the Jugendvollzugsanstalt Frohe Zukunft, Good Future, in Halle. On November 9th, 1989, the inner German border was opened. Bert Kreiser missed the fall of the Berlin Wall. One of the guards came to him and said, "I've been over there. What about you?"